Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to take you through the main design interface of Canva. So once you get into Canva onto the website, this is the main page you'll come across, and we're just going to create something from scratch and show you the different interface. So go over to create a design and click, and then you'll have a wealth of different options to choose from. Just scroll down. Once you've decided on your particular project, I'm going to select A4, just click, and it will take you to the main design interface. So what we're going to do is go through all of these elements and show you exactly what they do and how to navigate through them. So at the top here, we've got design, and really this is all of the different templates that are available to you. Now, you can just simply scroll down. If you do, you might see one of these with a crown on. If there's a crown on it, it means you can only access it if you have the pro version. I don't, so this is not available to me. That's fine, there's plenty of free options. If you don't see what you want on the left, just go up to search and then you can simply type in what you want. Let's select poster. And again, scroll down to find a suitable poster for your needs. So let's go down to a particular poster design, just click on it, and it will be inserted into your page and give you full access to edit any of the different options by simply clicking on them, changing the colors, changing the design. So let's say you wanted to change the color of this, select it, go to the color option here, and you can select from any color. If you want to go back to the original, you can see that the document colors are at the top here. Just select the correct one and then just go back to design. Additionally, if you go back here and then go to styles, Canva will give you a range of different color options for your poster. So let's say you weren't quite sure about these colors. Just click on any of these color palettes and Canva will change those color palettes and give you some different options. Perfect. So the next option is elements. And this is really the main one that you'll use when developing your design, because this has all the different elements like graphics, stickers, photos, text, all sorts of things within this interface. So at the top here, we've got recently used, but if you carry on going down, you've got lines and shapes. If you click on that, you'll be taken to this menu here. You can simply click on any of these and it will just be entered into your design. You're free to move it, resize it, and place it wherever you like within your document. Again, you can fully customize it. You can go up to colors, you've got borders, that sort of thing. But if you don't want it, just simply press delete. Go back using this button here. And then if you go to graphics, select see all. And again, you can scroll down, but normally you want something very specific. So go to the search bar at the top. Let's put in clock. And again, Canva will give you all the different clocks available to use in your design. Let's go back. The other thing I want to show you, I think stickers are fairly self-explanatory, and photographs, videos, etc. But if we go down to frames, I'm just going to show you how to use frames, because again, this is a really good tool for design. So frames, let's go to see all. So these are placeholders really for images. So these can be inserted into your design. So let's just click on this one here. Again, it can be resized. Let's just move it down. But what you can now do, if we go to photos, so go back, go to photos, click see all. If you click and drag a photo across into frames, you can see how that photo is being inserted into those different spaces. If you want to change the photograph or change the position, double click on it, and then you can move the photograph up and down. And then when you're happy, just press enter. If you don't like the image, you don't have to delete it. All you need to do is go and grab another photograph and then click and move it over the top. And then as you can see, we can move photos to the other frames and then this one to there as well. Again, if you're not sure about it, you can move it and press enter. And then what you can do is move this frame anywhere you like around your design. And again, we can resize it as well. And it's really, really versatile. So frames are excellent to use in your designs if you're using a photograph. And then if you don't want those photos, just click and delete. And if you don't want the frame, just click on the frame and press delete. Next, you've got the brand tab. If you select this icon here, you'll be taken to an area where if you have the pro version, you can upload all of your logos, your colors, fonts, photos, graphics, and icons. This means that when you're developing your design and you want your brand to be included, it's really easy to grab those elements and insert them into your designs. You don't have to go back and look for files on your computer, download the different aspects of it, and then try to insert it. But as I say, this is only available for the pro version. Go to uploads, and here you'll find all of the images that you've uploaded. So for example, if you wanted to upload an additional photo, just go to upload files, select an image of your choice, click upload, and you can see your image here. Once it's uploaded, just click on it and it will be inserted into your design. The next one is text. If we click on text, you've got lots of different options here. If you just want to insert a basic text, select one of these, just click on it, and you can see it will be inserted into your design. You can move it around. Then you, once it's highlighted, you can then type. If you want to change the fonts and things, you've got all of the options across the top here. You've got fonts, so you can just select a different font. Your font sizes, your colors, so colors of fonts here. And then underline, your upper and lower case, your alignment, effects, animation position, and your transparency. So those are all the typing different options. So if we go back to text, there's also a lot of fun options as well. So if you fancy something like this, again, just click on it, highlight it. So you can click on just this type here, press type, and this one here. If it doesn't type, double click on it, and press type again. If you don't want those, then simply select the text and press delete. If something goes wrong, just press Command or Control Z to go back, or you can just select it and press delete. So those are your text options. Draw is fairly self-explanatory. Just select a pen size, go down and select your color, and then go down here to select the width of your pen and the transparency with the slider here. Let's just choose this one here, and then you can go ahead and simply draw. If you don't like it, go to the eraser here and just click over the top of it and it will get rid of it. Projects. These are all your previous projects or projects you're working on that you can go back to. You also have the ability to put them into folders or your purchased items and your favorites. And again, your images will appear at the bottom, everything that you've uploaded. So that's a really simple one. You've also got designs across the top here that you've designed, your folders and your images across the top. The next one's really useful. This is where you can use all the additional apps to access other elements if you wish to do so. So for example, if I scroll down, you'll see some apps here that you'll recognize. So Pixabay, that's an online image resource, so free images. So if I just click on that, you can see all free images will appear. I don't have to go to the website, download them, upload them to Canva. It takes all that hassle away. If I want to search for a particular thing, again, let's put clock in, you can see that I'm now presented with all of the different options for a clock. If I go back to the apps and scroll down, you can also see that you can use your Facebook images, your Dropbox images, and lots of other different options as well. So that's a really useful tool to have. Once you're happy with your design, so I've selected a free poster design. If you want to download it, go to Share, go down to Download, select your file type up here. I'm going to select JPEG and simply click Download. Then at the bottom here, you can see it's downloading. And once it has, it will just go to your normal download file. So I hope that's helped you today to create some designs for yourself. I haven't gone through how to actually create stuff because that's in another video, and I will link it in the description below. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.